So this is my 69 Chevelle, and as you can see, I have manual brakes. So I went online and I bought a drum to disc conversion kit. Here's some of the parts here, like they're all over my car right now, no parts everywhere. So what we're going to do today is install the power booster. So let's do it. Going through my kit, and I have the proportioning valve, which mounts to this bracket, and this bracket mounts right here. So I'm going to install this bracket and pre-install the proportioning valve so I can install the booster onto the car. Just remove the front lines. There's front lines over here. So I got the front brake lines removed, the old proportioning valve, I discontinued it from the frame, and the front brake lines, and of course the master cylinder. Make the progress. Okay, I didn't do a closing update last night before I was done, so at the end of day two, I was able to get everything installed that I was looking to do. Like I said, I got the front brake lines pulled, and the new passenger side brake line is ran and secured. Got the power master cylinder secured, hooked it up to the brake pedal, and I'm really tired. So today what I've decided to do is work on the rear. So don't make fun of my crazy concoction here, but I went ahead and raised the front of the car, put it on some drive-up ramps, but put like a chalk behind it because the front end's not done yet. So there is nothing really holding the, well, I don't want to say hold the tires on, but I didn't finish the front setup, so there's no brakes whatsoever. Now the brake lines are hooked up. As you can see, the upper upper and lower ball joints have not been replaced yet. Those should be coming in pretty soon. So while I'm waiting on those, I still wanted to go ahead and make some progress. So I'm going to go ahead and start on the rear, run those brake lines, and see if I can pull the rear end. Maybe try to take the axles out. I don't know. We'll see, because it's been kind of rainy today. So I jacked up the car, put on some ramps. Ramp over there, ramp over there. Like I said, I chalked both the tires, try to help prevent it from rolling at all. And as a third safety measure, I went ahead and put a jack stand in the middle, a 2x4 and a cross member. So just in case one of these ball joints or something do fail, the car's not gonna fall, my head coming. Right up. So, all right. So we're gonna go ahead and jack up the rear and go from there. I will give you an update soon. Yes, it looks kind of crazy, but you do what you gotta do. We'll get her installed. Okay, a little day three progress update. Forgot to check in earlier. So what we've done is remove the rear tires. I have taken the drum off. I have removed the lower control arm here, removed the spring, and removed the shock. So trying to do is pull this rear end all the way out. Still have the upper control arms and the lower control arm on the other side. So right now we're moving the drive shaft underneath the joints out, and we're going to go ahead and pull the entire rear end so it's easier to work on. You got to pull the gears out and get the drive axles out. So I'm just trying to get a little update progress here. So as you can see, there's stuff everywhere. Here's my son getting all greasy. He woke up late, but he's finally here. So no chance. Okay, back to work. I'm gonna give a little progress. Day three update. So we've made a lot of good progress. Completely pulled out the rear end. As you can see over here, this is my rear end. That doesn't look too bad. Nice little 12 volt. We have the upper control arm bushings here and here. And we are definitely going to replace those. We're going to run all new brake lines. Getting ready to try to pull out these axles so we can get these packing plates off and then begin to install the new parts for the disc brakes. So I'm going to go into the car and I'll document that a little bit. Here's the new springs that we had put in a couple months back. So yeah, we are getting there. Okay, so this is the update wrap up of day three. I was able to take the entire rear end out, take it apart, pulled the axles out and installed the dust shields for the new disc brakes, put it all back together. Also was able to hammer out the bushings for the, the upper control arms. So that's all done, buttoned up. Have not put oil back in the differential because I put some gasket sealer on top of the gasket in there, so it's drying. As you can see, I was able to get down here, remove the upper and lower control arms, so they were all pulled. And tomorrow I'm gonna start putting the bushings on. So lots of great progress today. I don't know, you really can't see it very well, but a bunch of empty holes. So everything has been pulled from the rear end. But yeah, you really can't see it. Let's see. Go over here. And right there's your control arms. Long one is your lower, short one is your upper. And I still gotta get those bushings out because they're pretty gnarly. But that'll be tomorrow's task. So day three wrap up. Great progress today. I'm very, 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 very happy. So we're getting there.